Today, we will learn what underpinning actually is, how to determine what type of best fits your home best. Oh,
sounds like dysarthria due to a brain aneurysm, but it's not.
Let's try again, will you?
How to determine what type best fits your situation. Also, I will talk about the methods of underpinning with a quick review of most important ones. Stay with us. Watch all the way to the end. And I have a surprise for you. I will tell you why you should get involved choosing the best underpinning options for your home. That's a surprise.
By explaining this, it's no longer a surprise.
Stick with us all the way to the end. Roll that logo bumper post-production. All ready? Put a sci-fi sound here, like... You know that underpinning is a method of reinforcing existing foundations. You probably looked it up on Google. Most likely, these methods of underpinning are recommended by engineers to fix sinking buildings and other foundation issues. Here in California, that we have earthquakes and liquefaction zones, among many other unstable hillsides and receding soils, underpinning may be the only salvation for your sinking home. So stay with us, you're gonna find out what you need for your home. Underpinning as a foundation repair solution basically consists of supporting failing foundations. In this case, if they're sinking or...
Let's try again, will you?
Underpinning as a foundation repair solution basically consists of supporting failing foundations, sinking or settling concrete slabs, all done from underneath using lots of concrete. That's what underpinning is pouring concrete to reinforce your foundation. So among the four major types of underpinning, which is number one, pith, the second is mass pouring, the third is beam and base, and the last one is pile, are usually recommended in order to lift and stabilize existing structures. So pay attention, and I'm gonna go back to talk about these four types, okay? They're just methods. So here we go. Although I will point out and explain only four types of underpinning here, there are many other types and ways of underpinning and stabilizing any foundation. So don't get stuck with these four kinds. Additionally, I'll go over the three types of piles that is commonly used on underpinning pile method. That's one of those four types, would be the pile method, and I'm gonna explain all the piles for that method. Because you are looking for it here on the internet, I will show some drawings to help you visualize them, because I'm sure you're not gonna even know what I'm talking about. Stick with me until the end to make sure to choose the right underpinning technique for your situation. And get some paper and a pen and write it down, okay? You're gonna need to know it. Run the title post-production right over here.
Love this video.
Okay, back to our regular programming. Let's talk about most important methods of underpinning. It makes me think about... Anyway, I want to tell you the four most common types of underpinning, because if you need to repair any foundation or any building that has a problem on the foundation, the right choice is paramount to successful outcomes. So if you choose the right underpinning method, then you get it right. In the four choices that I will give you, you find the ideal one for your situation, because they cover just about any situation. Before you go on, please subscribe, like, and ring that freaking bell. It means a lot to bring this Understood? Okay, let's go on. I don't need to know what I said over there. Neither do you. So, number one, Pith method or hole method. This is the most common and the easiest kind of underpinning. And I say easiest because it's easy to understand. Watch our video entitled, Surprise, Surprise, Underpinning. Just look it up. You're gonna find in our channel. That one has even drawings and designs, so you're gonna like it. Usually the foundation is divided into regular spaces, like 3 or 4 feet sections, unless the structural engineer stipulates otherwise. You need to know that engineers tend to ask you to do a whole bunch of other things that's not what you planned initially, and they may change the plan right in the middle of the things. Next, one section at a time is excavated under the foundation wall, just above the plinth level. You don't know what a plinth is? Just look, put it over here, so you know what a plinth is. And it's a difficult name for you to pronounce, but it is easy to visualize. Then the foundation pit is dug, and the new foundation is laid underneath according to the engineering recommendations. Did you get it? Use steel, hardware, and proper concrete PSI as per plans. Don't take recommendations from your supplier. And number two, the mass pouring method. This type of underpinning is used in situations that require shallow underpinning, but not a lot of digging. So workers like to do this one instead. In this method, the weak soil under the surface is excavated and concrete is poured in its place to straighten the base just on that location. So check out this drawing over here. See? This is what I'm talking about. Now you know. Engineers go balls deep into this design. Sometimes they recommend stuff that you go, damn, dude, do I have to do this? Look at this picture over here, a job that we did in Santa Monica. Let me go over to the third kind, which is beam and base method. This method utilizes a traditional mass concrete base along with supportive beams to ensure the foundation is stable. Look at this one here. This one tells what I just said. All those words means this, okay? The weight of the foundation is supported by beams constructed below or above the foundation, but it supports the foundation and anything above it, okay? These beams distribute the foundation weight and transfer it evenly to a massive concrete base. So it is designed to hold the house in place. Number four, pile method. This is the method commonly used by foundation companies that invested in the right reusable hardware. So, you know, they need to have certain equipment that they are not renting. It's theirs, so they're gonna offer that option for you, and it's the most common in the market anyway. In the pile method foundation, piles, also known as foundation piers, are installed at equal distances along the foundation to lift it up and transfer the weight of the home off of the unsteady concrete underneath. So, did you visualize this? No? This method is particularly useful in expensive, erosive, or waterlogged soils. So if it is all sinking, you need a pile and you jack it up and put the house back in place. Though this is a common solution performed by foundation repair companies, there is a lot of variations between repair jobs based on this type of piers and the types of piers used. So always consult a structural engineer that can examine the foundation issues and come up with a personalized solution that fixes your problem and fits your budget. Engineers, especially structural engineers, can actually recommend what type of piers or what type of system that you should use in each case. So always consult a structural engineer that can examine the foundation issues and come up with a personalized solution that fixes your problem and fits your budget. Now I will explain the types of piers to be used on the pier method that I just mentioned. There are a few different kinds of foundation piers for the pile method of underpinning. So let me go over them one by one, okay? There are not that many anyway. These are the three different kinds of piers and their unique advantages. First is called resistant or push piers. It's kind of obvious. It is pushed into the ground, so that's why it's called push piers. This type of pier is driven into the ground right by or under any sinking foundation. They are driven down mechanically until it reaches stable soil with enough resistance to support the house. Once anchored into the ground, the pier is hydraulically lifted to raise the foundation back to its leveled state. Second, let's talk about helical piers. Helical, you know what helical is? No? So look at this picture over here. So helical piers, this kind of pier works the same way as the resistant piers. However, what makes helical piers unique is their threaded shafts. Let's talk about shafts. The thread on these piers allow them to work like screws as they are twisted into the ground. Let's talk about screwing. This gives them some added stability for light structural loads and is easily installed. Third, I will address the next type of pier. That's the drilled concrete piers. And the name is drilled concrete because, yeah, you drill and then you pour concrete. But let me explain it a little bit better. To install these piers, a hole is drilled for each pier and a set of steel rebars are tied in a cage and placed into the hole. Concrete is then poured into the holes, covering the rebars. Then, hydraulic jacks are placed on the piers and used to lift the foundation. Once the foundation is lifted, spacers are inserted to stabilize the foundation and the jacks are removed. These piers are a great option for many types of foundation repair. That's why it is used so often. Because they do not require extensive excavation or the replacement of the entire foundation. That's the reason why they're chosen. If you see any sort of foundation issue in your home, like, let me think, slab cracks, bowing or leaning basement walls, or a wall or a ceiling crack, sloped floors or sticking doors or sticking windows, or any kind of masonry that has cracks in it, these are good options for you because clearly you need underpinning. But if you poke around in our channel, you may find a video with the exact solution for you and how it's done. But our attorney wants me to say something here that's important. Underpinning projects are not for the do-it-yourselfer. These projects, I call it for the do-it-worselfer because you're only going to make it worse, you know? Worselfer. I think you get the gist of it. Yeah. Just to reinforce to all the dumbasses out there, even guided by plans and recommendations from engineers, it can go terribly wrong. This is not for do-it-yourselfers. These projects have no margin for errors. So like, subscribe, or call our sponsors. They can give you an estimate. I may be the one going to your house to do an assessment. Like, subscribe, and comment below telling us exactly what you need, and possibly we're gonna make a video out of it. So check out my personal channel, Trice Walker's World, where I say whatever I want. This is a plug, people, help a brother out. Thank you for watching another one of our videos here, Explanation, where our goal is to help you do construction right. And make it edgy. I think you're gonna like it. Woo! Give them something. Bye now.